Hi everyone, this is Fabian Müller and I want to tell you something about Beethoven's Appassionata. The Appassionata Sonata by Ludwig van Beethoven is one of his most famous pieces and in my opinion it's also one of the best pieces that has ever been composed. It's really, really absolutely breathtaking. This sonata has three movements, like most sonata have. It's a fast one, then a slow one, and then again a fast one. The first movement of the Appassionata Sonata is full of contrasts. It doesn't start with a loud and big statement or something, but it starts with a soft pianissimo opening like a question. So this opening is very dark and mysterious, and it's in F minor. But immediately after that, Beethoven repeats the same question, but in major, so in a much brighter and more hopeful way. And in fact, all the themes in this movement appear in major and in minor. It's like these two strong forces who are always fighting against each other. And the reaction to this fight in the beginning is the very famous fate motif, knocking on the door. You all know this from Beethoven's Fifth Symphony. And here in the sonata, he used the same motif, the same rhythm, but in the beginning, very low, very quiet, like a dangerous threat or something. Yeah, and from this moment on, this movement is always changing between parts that are very wild and angry and parts that are more beautiful and melodious. And you can, everywhere in this movement, you can hear the fate motif. Actually, just where I stopped, I play in my left hand, which is the same like, but just half the tempo. Also, you have to know that when Beethoven composed this piece, he was already having big difficulties with his hearing. And I think you can really feel in this piece that he was suffering a lot. The second movement is very different than the first one. It's not chaotic at all. It's very calm, it's very peaceful, it's very well organized, and it starts with a beautiful chorale. There's one harmony I like especially in this theme. It's this one. I don't know the English word, but if you would be very technically in German, you could call it a verminderte Doppeldominante mit tief alterierter Quint im Bass. And it brings something exotic to this already very beautiful theme. Now Beethoven does two things. He repeats this theme and takes it higher and higher on the piano. And also he makes it more and more moving. So in the beginning we have slow quartos. And then we have eighth notes. Then we have 16th notes. And then we have 32nd notes. And the theme now is really high also, and it's one of my absolute favorite passages because in the beginning the theme was already so hopeful, but now it's really very passionate and It's like it's illuminated. And I feel that you can imagine that this is composed by a man, by Beethoven, who always believed in a better world for everybody. And this is not just, you know, some nice music or something. At least in my opinion, this is much, much more. The second movement does not end as peacefully as it started, but something strange is happening, and then it goes immediately into the third movement without any break. And the third movement is just one continuous dark wave that never stops. Yes, and for me, this whole movement feels like you can't run away. It's the last fight against your own fate. And there's one moment where Beethoven takes a motif from the second movement where he was so happy, this one. These five chords, which are actually just an extended version of the fate motif, and he transforms it into something very dark. And also, he makes it very fast and super angry. Yeah, and then finally the whole thing kind of accumulates in an absolutely crazy Hungarian dance where it's like you completely lose your mind before the whole piece then ends in one big crash or one huge catastrophe.